Holy greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I am the Apostle Designate Minister John E. Ross, lead minister and founder of the Omega International Prophetic Ministries, and you are listening to the 2018 Image Award winning and Spin Award winning Let's Talk to the Lord Gospel Radio Talk Show. And this is Season 3 of Let's Talk to the Lord. And Kingdom, our guest for this episode is Everett Drake. Everett Drake is a singer, songwriter, and longtime vocalist for the famed popular Bobby Jones television program for over 25 years. Everett Drake has also toured with artists representing a variety of music styles. Kingdom, our topic of discussion on this episode is encouraging words for the indie artist. Dr. Everett Drake, please begin our discussion and let's go to the Word of God.
Mr. Ross, good evening, sir.
Praise the Lord.
How are you?
I am blessed. How are you, sir?
I'm doing great, thank you. I just want to say thank you for this awesome opportunity to share with your listening audience. I count it a privilege.
Yes, sir.
I tell you, in this season of my life, I find myself empowering and encouraging our independent artists because I am an independent artist myself.
Yes, sir.
And being a part of that platform of Bobby Jones Gospel there at BET and now on the Impact Television Network has given me a voice to hopefully share some information and some knowledge as I travel with our independent artists. As a matter of fact, I've been offered a television show that we're going to be partnering with BGN Television Networks. They're streaming television with Dr. Archie Harrison. And the name of the show is going to be Everett Drake in Tune with Indies. And the show is designed to, as I say, educate and empower our independent artists to help them understand what they're getting into, how to encode their music, and a lot of things that our independent artists will run up against not having the machinery of a record label to help them with. As you may know, a lot of our independent artists are doing things themselves in their home studios and all, and don't know that you encode your music as it's being recorded, because a lot of us are used to having it done for us in the studios. But if you're doing it at home yourself, you may not know to do that. And we want to be able to provide some reputable people through this television program to help our independent artists in many capacities, dealing with management and booking, production and recording, songwriting and publishing, social media and marketing, distribution, and a lot of the things that we're involved with that we need knowledge about. And that's what it will be. It's an informative talk show that talks about the things that we need to know about. I will be interviewing industry professionals where I can provide some reputable people for our independent artists to invest with. I hear so many times that our independent artists don't want to invest in themselves, but I beg to differ. Some of us have been robbed so much that we don't know who to invest with. So I pray that God will bless and anoint this effort that we can get some knowledge out to our people. As I often say, you know, in these conferences and things that I go to, I want independent artists to, you know, continue to pray that God will give them the right things to say and direct their paths so that when God gets ready to move, they'll be ready to move.
Amen.
And also want them to continue to practice your craft. You know, nobody wants to serve anymore in this day and time. You know, Brother Ross, you know, we've gotten to a point that nobody wants to sing on the praise team anymore, sing in the choir and serve. When, you know, so many times we think we're doing something for somebody else. But in fact, it's doing something for us. That's how I learned to do what I do today. I still work in the music ministry at my home church here in Nashville, Tennessee, First Baptist mm-hmm. Church, South Englewood, where I've been a member and working in the music ministry for over 50 years now. Mm-hmm. Even in all of my traveling and working and singing, mm-hmm. I go back and devote my time to my home church with hopes of being able to inspire some young person to follow their dreams. You know, and you really haven't learned anything till you can share it, you know, with someone else. So, you know, be found practicing your craft, you know, continue to work, you know, especially if you're a singer, your voice is a muscle like any other muscle. The more you use it, it builds a muscle, and it will work for you. If you're a musician, you can be the greatest musician in the world, but if you don't get out among other musicians, you know, and sit in with bands and things, nobody will know what you can do, so nobody will be able to refer you to anything. You know, be found practicing your craft. And then also, finally, talk about associating yourself with people who are doing what you want to do.
Yes.
And that's probably one of the most important things you could ever do, because that is how you network with others and people can see what you're really doing. And you go and you learn from everybody. If it's no more than what not to do. I started doing studio work here in Nashville, Tennessee at the recording studios, working for country music artists and some of the gospel artists. I wasn't making any money. I was going because my friends were going. They were working and making money. But I went to see what to do so that if given an opportunity, I would know how to conduct myself and what to do.
Yeah.
And one time we went to a session. The producer wanted a larger sound than the three singers that was there and asked him, sir, can he sing? Bring him in here, let him sing too. And that began my actual working in the studio. And then they began to get more work than they could handle. So they started passing work off to me, and I started hiring singers to go and do work with me. And that began an association to keep us all working.
Yeah.
You know, and one thing led to another, referrals. I was doing house vocals for a gospel record label, Nashville Records, there in Woodland Sound Studios. And it was housed in, as I said, in Woodland Studios, but many of the country music stars recorded there at that time as well. And we got a lot of work doing all work for a lot of country music stars, Eddie Rabbit, Brenda Lee, Ronnie Millsap, Oak Ridge Boys, Donna Fargo, and many others of that time. And from those experiences, I went on to tour with Donna Fargo and toured with her for many years. And I mention her in particular because I call her one of my musical mentors. She and Ambassador Dr. Bobby Jones, of course, and that platform of Bobby Jones Gospel, and then Mr. Lyle Lovett and his large band. I toured with him for several years. So they helped me to become whoever I am as a professional.
Yeah.
And, you know, that word professional, it encompasses a lot of things. And the first thing it encompasses is being on time.
Yeah.
And a lot of us don't want to show up on time. And that is one of the most paramount things involved with being a professional. And I just hope that we can learn to treat one another like we want to be treated and have the respect for one another and respect for those that are in charge to give us instructions and help us to be the sponge that we need to be to grow to where we need to grow, you know. And I'm just grateful for those individuals that I spoke of because they allowed me to practice my craft. And they shared their stages with me and gave me an opportunity to watch them, who were consummate professionals, do what they do every night and sometimes twice a night, and how to engage your audience and all the things that are involved. And it's so much you can learn when you're involved with situations. And, you know, I just admonish our independent artists to be mindful of your situations and the places God leads you and enables you to go and your surroundings and who you come in contact with, because nothing is, you know, by chance. It's all directed by God, and if you pay attention, you can learn so much as you take your journey through this life. It's a faith walk, needless to say, but it's a blessing, and I'm just grateful to have an opportunity to do what I love to do every day of my life, and it's nobody but God that would allow you to do this. I'm grateful to have a pastor and a covering, Pastor Napoleon Harris, and my home church, First Baptist Church, South Inglewood, that allow me to do what I do and welcome me back with open arms. And the Ambassador Dr. Bobby Jones, I've been with him almost 35 or 40 years now, and he's always been open to allow me to do other things and welcome me back with open arms. He said when I first went to work with him that there would always be a place for me at Bobby Jones Gospel, and he's been a man of his word, and it's been a blessing, and I just am grateful.
Amen. And Kingdom, our topic for discussion is encouraging words for indie artists. And let me begin by declaring in agreement with you, Brother Drake, that we definitely need to strengthen, encourage, and support indie artists. We want to encourage in spirit their hearts and minds, meaning, again, cause of strength, of purpose to encourage, suggest the raising of one's confidence. We want to raise the esteem of the independent artist to keep reaching for higher and be wise in your speech and actions. And to be effective in that area, we must acknowledge God, the Holy Spirit, before we speak. And likewise, in the artist, we must be encouraging to one another. We have to forgive one another. We have to be understanding. And I say be understanding with zero gossip. Amen. Yeah. Share our knowledge with one another and stay humble and focused on our Christ relationship. Jesus Christ is the core of being all and the best artist God has created you to be. Know your strengths as well as to continue building up those weak areas, because God's power and strength is made perfect in helping us to be an overcomer in each and every area. So let's all keep it real. In today's society, Christ has got to be the rock, because along with dealing with life as a follower of Christ, we can at times have the extra obstacles of trying to be a successful in an industry that tries to push us to the bottom. Just based on the facts of being in gospel music, Jesus sacrificed his life and yet was hated and rejected. Likewise, gospel music is at the bottom of the music industry. And because we are independent artists, sometimes we're even further down. And usually we have, unless we have a strong support or financial backing, we have to bear the expense of contracts, studio time, paying singers, mixing, mastering, and producing. That includes the music videos, promotions, airplay, travel, etc. It can be very expensive trying to get your music to the masses. It can be very expensive, and with that in mind, we have the popularity contest, the critics who will try to discourage you, and much more that I have not mentioned, along with receiving invitations to display and minister your gifts and talents in these areas. Man, we seem to be defeated before we can even get started. So it's going to take your fruitful, holy, pure relationship with God through Jesus Christ to help us to supernaturally overcome these and many other struggles that come with an indie artist who is in relationship with God through Jesus Christ. So that as we grow authentically to be who God has created us to be. Because prayerfully, we pray that we, by God the Holy Spirit, can, with this message, pour into you, not just compliment you, And with that in mind, our foundations must be made solid by the word of God. When
yes.
Paul founded the church of Ephesus, the Ephesians church, they worshiped Greek gods. That was the city's main attraction. And some of those who practiced those cult practices thrived as well. So Paul wrote this letter for the followers of Christ to be unified during this very dark time spiritually. Lucifer's desire is to sift us away from God, and we cannot stay strong if we are fooled to play in Satan's divide and conquer tactics. Satan's kingdom is a solidly united kingdom. They don't divide against themselves or side against one another. And if that illusion exists among us that Satan's kingdom can be divided, it will not only be to the destruction of God's kingdom and its purposes. In Ephesus, the 4th chapter and the 13th verse, Paul declared, "Therefore, I, the prisoner of the Lord, implore you to walk in a manner worthy of the calling with which you have been called, with all humility
yes.
and gentleness, with patience, showing tolerance for one another in love, being diligent to preserve the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace." And that's what it will take for us to overcome by the power of God, the Holy Spirit, and come out on the other side. And that's when, not if, but when we all become that kind of support system for all rising artists. Brother Drake, we need more time, but for now, please introduce yourself to the kingdom.
Well, as you stated before, many people know me from the platform of Bobby Jones Gospel there at BET all those many years. And those that may not know me personally, I'm the light-skinned brother on the front row that points. And it's just a blessing to have been with you this evening. If you would like to reach out to me, of course, I'm on all the social media outlets. You can reach me on Facebook as Everett Drake. There's no E on the end of Everett. It's EverettDrake. My website is www.everettdrake.com. Of course, I'm on Instagram as MR_AGRT, as in Amen Goes Right There. And, Brother Rush, you know that's my signature song.
Yes, sir.
That Amen Goes Right There. And of course, you can go to your favorite digital download store and get a copy. It's on iTunes, Amazon, and wherever you get your music, you can reach out and get that. I'd also like to say that I am available to come to your church, to your city, and share with you for worship services, concerts, whatever the case may be. I am available. Contrary to what people may think, because of that little box we call the television, people seem to think you make charge so much money because of that. But I am available, and you'd be surprised. I'd be more than happy to come and be a part of whatever you're having. I thank God for this opportunity. You can book me through J. Bender Entertainment, a young man here in Nashville. Jimmy Bender handles all of my contracts and travel arrangements. His number is area code 615-873-0646. Again, that's 615-873-0646. Or you can reach out to him by email at jbendere@gmail.com. Again, that's jbendere@gmail.com. Blessings to you, Minister.
And Brother Drake, do you have any final words that you would like to say to the indie artists?
Well, mainly at this point, I just want to invite everyone to be on the lookout for the new television show that's coming.
Yeah.
I will be advertising it more here in the very near future. It should be launched by the fall of this year, 2019, on BGN Television Network. That would Dr. Archie And we're just excited about it. Again, it's called Everett Drake, In Tune with Indies. And be on the lookout for it. It'll bless your life. We hope you'll be tuning in regularly so you can get as much knowledge as possible from these industry executives and people that work in the industry that can help you do what you do. We need knowledge. Knowledge is power, and that's what we need in order to make it in this ever-changing world of gospel music that we're living in.
And please introduce the music we will hear during this podcast, God Cares.
Oh, God Cares is a wonderful, wonderful song. As a matter of fact, it is the remake of the project that I have, Amen Goes Right There. My producer, Derek Lee, and I went away to write for the CD, and after writing all the songs, he said every new artist should have at least one cover tune on the project. And we searched for a long time, Minister Ross, just to try to find a song that voiced the sentiment of the songs that we had written. And just in conversation, he said to me, he said, you know, God cares. I said, yes, he does. He said, no, that's the song. I said, oh, okay. And God Cares was a song that many of us probably never knew who actually wrote the song, because it was passed around in our churches in the 60s. Every young adult choir and every choir in America sang that song. Like I said, most of us probably didn't know who wrote it, but the song is actually by evangelist Rosie Wallace out of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Mm-hmm. And it was a very big song in the 60s. And I'm very proud to say that I think we did a very classic presentation of the song, and it's been a major blessing in my life.
Amen. And Kingdom, before we go, Let's Talk to the Lord can be heard on iHeartRadio, Facebook, Speaker.com, TuneIn, Spotify, Alexa. And YouTube, and Elation Radio. Please join our group working on the Let's Talk to the Lord Gospel Radio Talk Show, and like our pages on Facebook. Last but not least, my single, Remember Now Thy Creator, which has been the opening song of my podcast, Let's Talk to the Lord, for the last 2 to 3 seasons, is available in all digital outlets, so please support me there. And indie artists, we pray that our hearts, your hearts, will be not become hardened by deceitfulness of sin and because of evil practices. Amen. Keep in mind, as Everett Drake has said, that practice makes perfect. So learn your craft well and present your best work. And remember, with Christ, we overcome the world, because we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against the evil forces in the heavenly realm. And may God bless you, and may God keep you, and may you remember always of God's love and God's cares for you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.